Hey, good morning, it's Rachel. Lately, I've had a lot of comments about our cattle panel trellises, and so I thought I would just do a quick tour of the tomato tunnel here and talk about what I like and kind of some of the drawbacks of it as well, in case people are thinking of doing the same. So first, what I like, because I like them in general quite a bit, they're sturdy, like they're really, really strong. You can kind of tell they're starting to get really loaded up with cucumbers and tomatoes. And no issues. They're durable. I've had these for several years now, and they perform very well year after year, which is helpful. And that also translates to really good value for the money. So you can get around here a single 16 foot by 50 inch wide panel for like $22. And so to do an 8 foot long trellis like this, you would only spend $44, which is not that bad. Compared to other options, especially considering how long they last. In our case, we couldn't fit that on the car, so we used 2 8-footers zip tied together, and it is more expensive that way. 8-footers are like 17 bucks, and the 16-footers are 20, so it would have been more affordable to do a big one. We just couldn't do it. So first is just durable and really good value for the money. Second, they just generally work really well, so it does hold the plants up off of the ground. It's very strong. I can weave the tomatoes just in and out here, so you can kind of tell. I just go like behind the panel, in front of the panel, and then here I'll just kind of wrap it around. When the growing tip is really pliable, you can just wrap it. So you don't have to tie things, it's really simple, and it just does a good job of holding the plants up and providing really good airflow. You know, normally I would start to have a lot of powdery mildew issues on things like cucumbers, but this panel just does a great job of enabling a ton of airflow. And it also makes it really easy to see, you know, when you're getting a sucker, you might want to prune off. So really, really like them from a functional perspective. From a just space efficiency, I need this walkway anyway in the garden. And so by putting the panels up and over, I essentially turn space that otherwise wouldn't be used for anything other than walking into productive growing area. Gotta prune as I talk to you guys, which is really, really good. The other note here about space efficiency, if you can zoom in here, because it's a grid, I can do a lot with the vertical space. So this is a determinate tomato. I think this is an Ace 55, and it's going to top out right around here. Maybe it'll get this tall. The two on the other side of it are indeterminates, and so what I've done is intentionally taken a sucker and let it grow, and I'm taking it up at an angle, and I'm doing the same over here with this guy, and both of these will grow together and take over this space. And so even though this tomato is gonna top out here, this isn't wasted space. I can trellis other tomatoes on it. I will say, going to the one more example of sucker use here, this trellis had 2 beans that drowned in our flood. And what I did is I let this tomato sucker grow and become a whole new tomato plant. And so again, I can take advantage of what otherwise would have been dead space. And then same with this cucumber. So at the very bottom, there's a sucker. I normally train to a single stem, but I let one sucker go and I've now trellised that up here. So again, I get 2 cucumber plants in the space, and it's not wasted or dead space. So again, very, very space efficient. That's the second thing I like about them. They were just easy to build, right? So you can see we hammered T-posts into the ground with a rubber mallet. We have a video on this if you guys want to look at it in detail. But basically, we just hammered it into the ground and zip tied the cattle panels to it. So one in the middle where 2 panels come together and they're zip tied, and then one at kind of each end, same treatment. That's just simple, it's easy. It's something anybody can do with no particular construction skills. And we just did it with stuff we had on hand. It's going to what I don't necessarily love about these. One is, I did this morning, so good timing. You can break off these tips. So, you know, it's nice and simple to weave them in and out, but if you do it when the stem has gotten, if you miss it, frankly, and I missed this one, and I tried to bend it when it was not bendable and pliable, and it just snapped the stem. That's just me being impatient. It's not an inherent flaw of the system, but I will say if you're going to trellis like this, you have to stay on top of when you do it when they're bendable and you're not gonna break them. So that's one thing that I have to keep an eye on when I trellis like this. But the real drawback is the accessibility of it. So from the inside, it's really easy for me to get to these tomatoes and cucumbers, but from the other side of the bed, I personally can only reach about 3 feet in. And so you can kind of tell here, this is like, I have all of my kale here and I can work that just fine. This strip right against the trellis is really hard to reach. And so in my case, that's where I put my pollinator plants. So I have borage and holy basil here and borage again. And then this side has borage and hyssop and more borage. So it's not necessarily a bad thing. You can use it for things like pollinator plants, but be aware, it's hard to harvest and do a lot of work if you do trellis like this, and if you use a bed that's deeper than about 3 feet. So we kind of turned it into a good thing by putting the pollinator plants there, but I will caution that if you're gonna do a 4 foot deep bed, you really wanna be able usually to work it from both sides. We knew this might be an issue, which is why I use it for the pollinators. And then one last note on the pollinator plants. Another reason I do like these trellises. Borage is my favorite, but it does tend to get floppy. And again, the nice thing about these being a grid is I literally will just pull the top of the borage plant through it. And it's not the prettiest thing in the world, but it works really well to hold the plant in place and keep it from flopping and breaking its stems. So again, overall, I would highly recommend this. I like it a lot. It's really productive, good value for the money, does a great job as a trellis. Just do be aware that you're gonna avoid too deep of a bed with it because it will create an inaccessible area. And don't snap off the tips of your tomato plants like I did. But otherwise, honestly, like, I love these. I use them every year. So if anyone's thinking about it, I do highly recommend them. Hope that was helpful. Thanks.